Yeah, today I'm going to fit a Chinese heater. It's a bit warm at the moment to talk about heating, but this van's going to be going to Spain in February and it's going to be pretty cold through the Pyrenees. I got this particular one on eBay. It's from China. I heard they're really good, but there's a lot of components that you want to change, especially the fuel line. So that's the full fuel line we're going to use. It's hard plastic, so it doesn't collapse. Let's have a look. It comes with a fuel tank, 1 litre I believe, I know 5 litres. Well, I won't be using this. I'm going to be tapping into the main fuel tank. I'm not going to actually go into the fuel tank. I'm going to be using the pipe from the return from the injectors. On these vans, on diesel vans, you have an injector. When it doesn't use all the fuel from the injector, some of it's taken back to the fuel tank. That pipe I'm going to tap into. I'll show you shortly. So that's no good. This is the pipe for the diesel heater to go through the floor. You bolt it onto there and then you screw this down to the floor. I won't be using this either. I think these are unsafe for this particular vehicle because the floor is not straight. It's actually concave. It's got ridges. So what I'm going to have, I've ordered one, I'm picking up tomorrow. It's going to have a round extension on here. So when it goes through the floor, it will fit better. Alright, this is the heater itself. It's a 5 kilowatt heater. You can get a 2 kilowatt and a 5 kilowatt. They're the same price, so you might as well go with a 5. You just turn it down if you don't want it so hot. This comes with a display, and also it comes with a little handy remote control. There's the exhaust pipe. Obviously it's bent like that. You can straighten it and bend it to what angle you want. That's the fuel hose I was talking about. You can see it's too collapsible. It can, over a period of time, just sort of collapse and then waste the time. So I'll be using that one. Needs, I won't be using that. Exhaust. Notice on his exhaust, got a little hole there, that's got to hang down like that, so any condensation will come out of it. I'm using one of them. So just to go over it again, here we have the plate which screws onto the main heater unit, which I won't be using. I've got a better one coming. Heater unit itself, 5 kilowatt. This is power cable and cable to control unit, which is the control unit there. This comes off from the back plate. You mount that to the vehicle and then that just pushes on. And remote control, key fob, fixing screws, air intake filter, exhaust cube, fuel pump, muffler, exhaust muffler. Fuel filter, again, I won't be using this fuel filter. I've got one picking up tomorrow, which is a bit of better quality. Apparently these can crack and leak. Here's all the fixings. Again, I've got better fixings in there. And the vents. I've got the tube for the vents, but again, I won't be using much of that. And this vent goes here. And fits to the air filter vent. This obviously fits on there too, and that fits on the other end. What you see is I've used part of the box and I've drawn around this unit to give me a template. I'm going to use this template. I'm going to cut around there and use this to see what room I got under the seat. Here we have the template drawn out and cut out. I'll be able to use that in the seat now at an angle like that, rather than use the unit itself, just to make sure the hole's in the right place on the floor. I'm going to be placing this underneath the driver's seat, and I'm just using that at the minute just for a template. So the first thing I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be taking the board out, and then I'm going to take both seats out, and then I'm going to lift up the flooring to get access to the floor of the body of the vehicle. Well, that's the seat removed from the base. To remove the seat from the base, you undo these there. These are in each corner. You've got the backing plate and two screws. A bit fiddly, I expect to get them back, but quite easy to take out. So once you've done that, I'll take this seat out. Only from the floor, I won't need to take it off the base. And then I will lift, undo the handbrake gaiter, lift the whole flooring up, so access to the floor of the body of the vehicle. And then I will put this temporary back, sitting on these, so it gives me the right height. And then I can determine with my pattern where the heat is going to go, and drill the hole for the bomb. Well, that's the seat removed from the base. To remove the seat from the base, you undo these there. These are in each corner. You've got the backing plate and two screws. A bit fiddly, I expect to get them back, but quite easy to take out. So once you've done that, I'll take this seat out. Only from the floor, I won't need to take it off the base. And then I will lift, undo the handbrake gaiter, lift the whole flooring up, so access to the floor of the body of the vehicle. And then I will put this temporary back, sitting on these, so it gives me the right height. And then I can determine with my pattern where the heat is going to go, and drill the hole for the bomb. Well, that's both seats removed. If anyone doesn't know how to remove the seats, you've got four bolts on the passenger side, so it's got 1, 2, 3 and 4. It just slips out of this one. Don't forget to undo this. There's an arm where you pull out on the other part, and then detach this. Make sure you undo that. You've got to undo the seat belt as well, and then you can remove. Same with this. This has 3 bolts and pulls out of that. Again, you got the airbag harness. The gaiter, it's got 1, 2, 3, 4 clips. Just give it a quick jolt up and that will come off, and just tuck it out the way like that. I've removed this unit here, which is the step. Again, all you have to do is undo a few screws. I think it's 3 of them. 1, 2 and 3. This is already undone because you removed the seat, and then just pull it under there, and then you can lift it up. I will pull this out the way. I won't remove that side, should be okay. And then what I do is lift it up out the way, and then put that seat rail back. This is the plate was installed with the heater. It's the same size. The only difference is the one I'm getting tomorrow has got a round circle here, so when it goes through the floor, it seals up the floor better. But this gives me the right height for the unit. So I'm going to be measuring from here all around the unit. This is where the plate's going to go. That is my pattern, which I drawed around the unit to give me an idea where it's going to go. You can see that it's going to be touching here slightly. And if you look, it doesn't reach the floor really. So I think that's going to have to come out of that back bar, which that's what most of them do.
I mean, I might get away with it if it's accurate enough. The only way to determine that is fit it. But the plate I've got is 3 mil. This is only about 1 mil. But that's roughly where it's going to be. Also, I might have to cut this back here, which is what they all do. They cut a little piece out here. So the first thing I'm going to do is cut the floor out. All right, I've marked out where the hole's going to be. This is what I was talking about with the ridges. If you use just a flat piece like that over the ridges, you've got a gap there. The one I've got has got a collar, and the collar goes through the body and it seals up better. So that's what I'll be using. Well, that's the hole cut. I'm going to be treating this around the edge so it don't get rusty. But you can see now the height of this. As the one I'm buying, it's got a flue on the bottom, a round flue, so it fits straight down and it's slightly bigger. Where this one, you've got gap here, which to me, once this is screwed down to the vehicle, you're going to have gaps here which you can seal, but I don't think it's a very good idea. So I suggest you buy a new plate. Here we have the harness for the heater. The red lead goes to the positive on the battery. In my case, I'm taking it to the fuse box, so hopefully I won't need this fuse there. I could cut that out. I'm going to make that the same length and run it to the fuse box as well on the negative side. This goes to the control panel, which is going to be inside the vehicle. And however, this is going to be on the outside of the vehicle because it fits to the pump, which is going to be on the outside. As this plug is too big, I'm not going to drill a hole in the van that size, so I'm going to remove the wire from the plug. A lot of people just cut the wire, and I don't think that's a good idea. If you look on the wire there, you will see a little tab. There is one this side and on the other side. I use these tweezers, which are quite sharp. I basically put it in the top. If you look, I put it in the top there, either side, and just slightly tweaked it as I was pulling the wire, and it comes out quite easy. Don't pull it too hard. Make a reference which side it goes to. The red obviously is to the left, looking at the plug this way. If you're not sure, take a picture. And then all I've got to do is drill a hole for the size of the two little wires. That's the wires now removed from the plug. I've just scratched a little tiny R on one side so I know that I won't get confused when I put the wire back. Just make sure you bend these little prongs there, the wings out slightly again. Just stick a little screw in there and just slightly twist it. Don't have to bend them out too far. These plugs are quite strong on the end, so don't worry about sticking your screwdriver in there, or they'll be okay. And all you do is push them in the end of the plug and they're locked in place. This plug is for the control unit inside the van. Again, it's a big plug, and if you just want to feed the wire through a small hole, then you will need to remove this plug. First thing you do is take a picture of the plug where the wires are. If you take it at that direction there, you can quite see that lever there and the shape of it and where the wires go. To remove this plug, there's a yellow tab here. If you get under the yellow tab, just tweak it up, put your screwdriver on the end, and you'll remove that tab. Try and do it one-handed, but there we go. Just pulls out, and then you've got three
metal prongs in there, and they're held in by the plug's plastic little lever here. So if I get hold of the black wire, just gently with a bit of tension on it, lift that prong just to the side and you'll pull it straight out, because the plastic has tiny little levers. You need to lift it out that way and they'll fall out. Careful not to do it too, because they're only plastic. Again, they're quite easy to put back. There we go. Simple as that. And then when you finish, job's a good one. Well, that's the seat base in place. I haven't fixed it down. This is the bracket in question. It's 3mm thick, and because this is not a straight piece of metal and it goes up and down here, this collar allows to cover, where the other one with the heater is just a flat plate, and also it's very flimsy. So this is more heat resistant, and I will be fixing it with two screws on this point here, and then put a mastic round before it's fitted, so that'll keep it in as well. You could have put spacers underneath here and drill the holes and put bolts in there, but it's not necessary. I'm just going to use two holes here and put two screws, and two screws here. Well, that's the heater temporarily installed, just to give me some idea. This bracket here, it goes all the way across. I cut that away. What I did is drilled a series of holes, used an axle there, wiggled it till it broke off, and then just used my file, which is an electric file sander, and just sanded it away nice and smooth, and then give it a coat of paint. I've also done the other side. I left this piece here because I need that point there to clip in the harness for the airbag. Also, I removed the bar at the bottom. You can't fit these without removing these, and I shaped it, give it a nice little shape there. Yeah, the flue I'm going to fit in the hole of the van is 125mm wide. The nearest drill I could get was 127. That's the nearest drill you can get. So 127, half of that, 63.5, half of that. So basically, if anyone wants to drill a hole in their van to get the right position, if you measure to the edge of here, to the middle of the hole, so it's a measure to the edge of that van there, to the middle of the hole, that's 83.5mm. And if you measure from that grommet, on the outside of the grommet, allow for 6mm to the edge plus 63.5, that's 69.5. So if you do from here to the middle, 63.5, and to the edge of the van all the way to the middle, that's 83.5, and that gives you the middle of the hole, and then cut it at 127mm, and there we got it. Close up of the bar, there's the bar at the back, that's the bar I cut out at the front. You can't see where I've cut it really, I've shaped it, and that's the under view of the piece I cut out, and down there. You want to know the size. Right, the first thing I'm going to do now is I'm going to get under the van and I'm going to mark where that circle is in the floor, because I'm going to cut a circle out of this carpet. And once I cut the circle out of the carpet, I can then fit this on top of the carpet
with the heater on and then draw around just the heater so it makes a nice fit. So now we've got our pattern drawn around, so I'm going to go and cut that out. I'll probably go and use a jigsaw, much easier. So let's get that cut out. Right. It's too difficult to cut out around this side, so what I've done is find this middle of the circle, stab it through, replicate the circle around there, i.e. measure the circumference of the circle, and draw around the flue, get the circle, and then make a little incision and then cut it out. Make sure there's no wires there. So that's the circle cut out. What I'll do now, stick the flue back over the hole. Make sure it's parallel. Make sure the heater's in the right way. The burner was the longest part from the flue. And you can see the burner through the hole anyway. And then what we do is mark around the burner itself. And then cut that out.
Paris, some